Hi everybody, it's the Modern Housewife with tips, tricks, crafts, and DIY projects. Today we're going to be making DIY roach killer balls, so stick around.
The things you're going to need for this project are an eighth a cup of Crisco, an eighth of a cup of powdered sugar, a half a cup of flour, and 1 cup of borax. Also have ready a bowl to mix them all in, and a small glass of water. I'm going to be using smaller measurements since I've already made this product for myself. Start with your eighth of a cup of Crisco. Take a spoon and scoop it all out into the bowl, trying to mash it up as best as possible. Next, add your eighth of a cup of powdered sugar. You may want to be cutting the Crisco into all the flour products, but I chose to just mix it all with a spoon. Next, add your cup of borax. I am using 20 Mule Team Borax Detergent Booster. You can find it at your local grocery store for about $5. Lastly, add your half a cup of flour. It doesn't matter if it's white or wheat. Mix all of the ingredients the best you can, trying to get the Crisco as stirred in as possible. Lastly, you're going to want to gradually add water until your product becomes a pasty, doughy texture. Make sure to add it gradually. You don't want it too wet and soupy, but you don't want it crumbly either. You're going to want it about the texture of pie crust dough. While we're waiting, you can go below and check out the link I posted for the full article on housewifehowtos.com. It's actually really nifty how these roach balls work. The Crisco and powdered sugar gives them something to eat, while the borax tears up their insides. They take it back to the nest and feed it to the whole colony, killing them all. Also note that borax and boric acid are not the same thing, although they are closely related. Boric acid will work much faster, but most people tend to use borax because they just have it around the house. Please remember, these are not safe for pets or children, so please keep them out of reach of your little ones or your furry friends. Don't forget to wash your hands and wipe down the area you prepped them in when you're finished. You may also want to vacuum the floors. Once you reach the nice doughy consistency, you're going to want to roll it into balls about the size of olives. You're going to want to stash two or three of these in each area where roaches are likely to gather, such as behind the fridge, in cupboards, or around appliances. I've been using these for about a week, and I can say I've seen a very dramatic difference. And there you have it, our super handy, super helpful DIY roach killer balls. You can store them either in an airtight container or in a berry container with the lid taped shut. You should mist these once or twice a day with clean water to keep their scent fresh. And we're done. That was simple, yet effective. Thank you for watching. For more tips, tricks, crafts, and DIY projects, please subscribe below. Thank you!